There are three subspecies of the surgeonfish roaming in the Caribbean: the blue tang, the ocean surgeonfish, and the doctorfish. The surgeonfish family bears its name based on the fact of sporting two small blades at their tail's base that are sharp as scalpel. A tank will raise those blades to defend itself, most commonly versus other males of the species. The blue tang often forms schools numbering more than 50 members and can be seen sliding in the reef looking for algae, a main part of their diet. There will often be some doctorfish accompanying them, but also fishes from other species, like trumpet fishes, who hides in the school in order to better surprise their unseen prey with lightning strike attacks. The blue tang is an herbivore, and the shape of their teeth stop the corals, limestone, and other detritus from being swallowed. On the other hand, its two cousins are omnivores, because they don't have the same teething, and while grazing, they also consume small organisms living in the algae. The presence of those three species in the coral reefs has been proven to be essential to its survival many times over, as episodes of their disappearance have resulted in the reef being rapidly strangled by algae. With the oceans warming, the algae strongly multiplies, and thus, the importance of these grazing fishes increases greatly. The surgeonfish, like numerous other fishes, show impressive color changing throughout their lives. For example, the blue tang is yellow in their juvenile stage, and as we have seen, the ocean surgeonfish sport a much clearer shade, passing from clear beige to deep brown. A last small piece of information. As sharks consume the surgeonfish's predators, their disappearance from a reef will lead to the small fish's decline. From cause to effect, the coral dies. At first sight, it's difficult to link those great beautiful beasts that are sharks to the tiny tanks, which aren't even part of their diet. Just as it's difficult to see the link between mankind, who hunts shark for their fins, and the disappearance of the corals. We must never forget that whenever we are attacking a single link, we weaken the whole chain.